A bunion is a bony bump resulting from a misaligned joint on the side of the big toe. A bunion is typically painful and may be unsightly. Bunions are primarily inherited, meaning they run in families but may be irritated or made worse by pressure from shoes. A bunionectomy is a procedure that removes the bunion and realigns the joint to relieve foot pain. There are several techniques used to repair a bunion, and this animation describes some of the more common techniques used today. Your physician can discuss details of your particular needs with you. A bunion is a deformity of bone and soft tissue that occurs at the joint between the big toe, or hallux, and the first bone in the foot, called the first metatarsal. The point where these bones meet is called the metatarsophalangeal, or MTP, joint. A variety of foot structure abnormalities that typically involve tendons and ligaments around the joint may cause the big toe to be gradually pulled toward the second toe. The head of the first metatarsal bone sticks out, resulting in a bunion that worsens over time. The tendons or ligaments that pull on the toe incorrectly may become overstretched and weak, or tight and thickened, and are often associated with swelling and pain. Additionally, a watertight sac surrounding the joint, called the bursa, typically becomes swollen, resulting in an even larger bump and increased tenderness.
We initially try to treat bunions conservatively with shoe changes and toe spacers, and then if that fails, there are surgical options for people. Bunion surgery tends to be a bigger surgery than people expect it to be. It tends to take longer to recover from and be a more painful procedure than they expect. And so I try to warn patients ahead of time that this is a fairly big deal. The surgery is fairly involved and requires a long recovery for people.
There are a variety of bunionectomy procedures, which generally include a combination of techniques to achieve the final result. Your physician will decide which procedure and options are best for you based on your specific condition. Bunionectomy procedures are typically performed in a hospital or outpatient center, where you will be permitted to go home the day of the surgery. You may be given general anesthesia, which allows you to sleep during the procedure, but more commonly, you will be given local anesthesia with IV sedation. In this case, your foot will be numb and you will be relaxed, but not entirely asleep. Your surgeon will make an incision on the top of your big toe or on the side of your foot to expose the MTP joint. The bump is removed first and will only correct the deformity temporarily if it's not combined with other repairs. Typically, a small wedge of bone is also removed from the first metatarsal in order to realign the joint. The bone is held in its new position with screws, pins, or plates. Additionally, loose tendons or ligaments often need to be shortened, or tight tendons or ligaments need to be lengthened by cutting and repositioning them. For those who have had previous bunion surgery, any damaged portion of the joint may need to be removed. Once all repairs and adjustments have been made, the incision will be closed with sutures and a bandage will be wrapped around your foot.
The first thing we worry about after a bunion surgery is recurrence. You can have your surgery and the bunion can come back. Different techniques with the surgery can help decrease that risk. But there's always a small risk that the bunion can come back. It ranges anywhere from 2 to 10% risk of recurrence. Another common problem is pain. People can still have some pain after their bunion surgery and correction. Most of that pain will go away with time, and that's why I tell people it takes 6 months to a year to completely recover. Swelling is a very common problem after bunion surgery. The swelling can take a long time to resolve. It can take up to 6 months to a year before all of the swelling is completely gone. Part of that has to do with just the location of the foot. It's as far away from the heart as you can get. Gravity is constantly pulling fluid and blood down into the foot, and that makes getting the swelling under control difficult sometimes. I tend to recommend use of compression socks and elevation and ice after surgery to help decrease the swelling problem.
Following the procedure, you can expect to have some pain and swelling and will likely be advised to keep your foot elevated for a few days to reduce swelling. Depending on the type of procedure, you may need to use crutches for 1 to 2 weeks to avoid bearing weight on your foot. Sutures are typically removed in about 2 weeks, and any non-permanent screws or pins will be removed at variable times, depending on the type of procedure performed. You may be required to wear a surgical boot or shoe for several weeks to provide support for your foot as it heals, and your physician may recommend foot and toe exercises to keep your toe from becoming stiff. Your physician will advise you about when you may resume other activities.
The typical postoperative protocol involves approximately 6 weeks of walking on the heel and the outside of the foot, either in a walking boot or a postoperative shoe. For the first 2 weeks after surgery, patients need to really rest and elevate their foot as much as possible to help with pain and swelling. After 2 weeks, they can be up and moving around in their boot, but they may need to rest and elevate it periodically throughout the day. One of the big problems for bunion correction on the right side is driving. That's always a question my patients ask, and typically it means that you can't drive for approximately 6 weeks when we fix the right side. You need to be back in a normal shoe and able to safely work the pedals in the car before you can return to driving. So typically it's approximately 6 weeks before return to driving after a right bunion correction. Approximately 6 weeks after surgery, you return to a wide toe box tennis shoe and start putting full pressure on the foot. By 10 to 12 weeks after surgery, I expect people to be walking fairly comfortably throughout the day with some mild swelling and discomfort at the end of the day. I expect people to return to light activity approximately 3 months after surgery. That involves things like the elliptical machine, golf, low impact walking, or even some light jogging. And then typically between 3 to 6 months after surgery, they've returned to all normal activities. Recovery from bunion surgery can take anywhere from 6 to 12 months before the foot is back to normal, all the swelling and discomfort are gone, and it's as good as it can possibly be.